In this video, we're going to be going over spin bike resistance and the two different types of resistance that exist, magnetic and friction. A critical aspect of the spin bike is the resistance, which is the opposing force you encounter when cycling. Resistance brings about a real cycling feeling, almost as if you were outdoors. During a class, you're able to adjust your resistance, which often makes it feel more difficult to pedal. This will require more force to turn a flywheel, but gives you a harder workout. There are two types of spin bike resistance based on the mechanisms employed. We'll take a closer look at both of them. Magnetic resistance is usually found on newer and more expensive models of spin bikes. This type of resistance places two magnets, similar to where physical brake pads would be. As you increase the bike's resistance using your resistance knob, magnets move physically closer or further away from each other, but they never touch the flywheel. Increasing resistance moves the magnets closer and makes it harder to pedal, while decreasing resistance moves the magnets further apart and makes it easier to pedal. Since there are no parts that touch, a spin bike with magnetic resistance is much quieter than one with friction resistance. Magnetic resistance bikes may be even totally silent. They will also require less maintenance over time. However, it's important to note that magnetic resistance spin bikes are typically more expensive than those that use friction resistance. Friction resistance uses cotton felt or wool pads, similar to brake pads, and looks similar to a real outdoor bike. When you increase the resistance, these pads physically move and squeeze the sides of the flywheel. Since the pads and flywheel touch, this type of resistance will wear out over time and need regular maintenance. You will notice this form of resistance on most budget spin bikes. Although they may generate some noise, they're typically quiet, only producing a low-pitched swishing sound if properly maintained. These pads also may need to be removed and realigned occasionally due to use. Both types of resistance are excellent as they both hold various levels of resistance best suited for your workout needs. The difference between them comes down primarily to cost and maintenance. If you don't want to perform much maintenance, we'd recommend a bike with magnetic resistance. If you're on a budget or are comfortable with performing maintenance checks, we'd recommend the friction. Our favorite magnetic resistance bike is the Sunny Health SF-B1805, and our favorite friction resistance bike is the Yosuda YB007A. We'll link these two in the description. In addition, we recommend checking out our website, commercialspinbikes.com, for buying guides and comparisons between bikes to help you choose the bike that's best for you.